Dave, we're on.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. Join Councilwoman Paget in the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Will you pray with me? Our Father in heaven, we just thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us and gives us hope and life for eternity. Father, we thank you for our country and for the veterans and for the military that guard our shores and keeps us safe. We thank you for this community, Father, and what a blessing it is to live here and enjoy the fellowship with other citizens. We thank you for bringing Leroy to us and allowing him to serve and help this community to be what you'd like it to be. And we just ask you bless his endeavor and his new job here, and help him to feel at home and comfortable in here, and help us to be what we need to be. So we just want to thank you, Father, for all these blessings, and we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Call to order our Guthrie Public Works Authority meeting, February 7th. Do we have any public comments? I've got a community announcement. Of course, it's the welcoming of the new face on the podium up here, our new city manager, Leroy Alsop. And some of you met him at the reception beforehand. Those of you that are viewing from a distance, Leroy comes to us as the top candidate from about 20 plus candidates that we had. Leroy was the unanimous selection by the city council to be our newest member of the leadership team. It comes with 30 plus years of experience in municipal and county governments. A whole bunch of C's: Coffeyville, Cushing, Coweta, Catoosa. Cali, Kansas, and then most recently from McAllister. When we were doing the vetting on him, I jotted down some of the comments that came from individuals that have worked with and for him at all of those locations. And the comments were things like knowledgeable, relationship builder, team player, honorable, highest integrity. Welcome to our leadership team, Leroy.
Thank you, sir. My wife and I are excited to become part of the Guthrie community, and I look forward to working with the Guthrie leadership team to move the community forward and maintain the quality that we already have.
Very good. Know that you will. The number three item on the Public Works Authority agenda is the consent agenda. Only one item, which is the approval of the minutes from January 17th.
So moved.
Second.
Is there a second? Is there any other second. Discussion? Okay. Submit your vote, please.
All votes are in.
See the votes? Unanimous approval of the consent agenda, which is the minutes of January 17th. Fourth item on the agenda is the discussion and possible action on resolution number 2017-04, the necessity for taking property for expansion and construction of a low water dam. Do we have any comments from staff?
That's my item, Mayor, we're going to discuss this in executive session. I think we've got a negotiated agreement on this. The resolution authorizes either negotiating the sale or eminent domain, so I'd request the resolution go ahead and be passed, but I think we will have a negotiated sale.
Okay. I'll entertain then a motion.
So moved.
And a second.
Second.
Any other discussion? Submit your vote, please.
All votes are in.
Let's see the votes. Unanimous approval of resolution 2017-04. With that, ladies and gentlemen, our Public Works Authority meeting is adjourned, and I call to order our City Council meeting of February 7th. The consent agenda, item number two, consent agendas A through K. A is the approval of our council workshop of January 17th. B is our approval of the minutes of our regular city council meeting of the same date of the 17th of January. C is approval of a budget amendment number six, which moves some money within internally within the grant fund and the hotel motel fund. D is approval of an award for street capital improvement. This was one of the things that the council approved at our last meeting, which is one of the first steps in paving a number of streets in our community. I think about 14 or so different segments of streets, so a very positive thing there. E is approval of approval to deny a tort claim, as recommended by OMAG. F is approval of accepting a grant award from the Homeland Security in the amount of $12,000+ to purchase radio equipment for the fire department. G is approval to renew a sports field agreement for with the Softball Association for Owens Field. H is approval of the sports field agreement with the Guthrie Public Schools to use the Kiwanis Field. That's for baseball. I is approval of the sports field agreement with the Guthrie Baseball Summer League for the use of Kiwanis Field. J is approval of renewal of the sports field use agreement with the Guthrie Baseball Summer League for the Cottonwood Flats.
K, Mayor, we'll not consider. We don't need that.
And that is the end of the consent agenda.
I want to pull C for more discussion here real quick.
Ask if anyone's here.
We're pulling K.
Okay.
Are we pulling K?
No, we're not going to consider it.
You're asking to consider C? Pull C?
Yes.
Okay. And is there anyone here, item number G, which was the a tort claim, is there anybody here that is responding to that that tort claim on I believe it was a fall on city sidewalk?
That's E, actually.
That's E.
Did I say E? Yes. Okay. Then item number C, you want to pull that for more discussion?
I move that we...
Yes.
Yes. Sorry.
Okay.
I move that we pass, pass A, B, D through J.
Okay.
Second.
Okay. Is there any other discussion? Okay, submit your votes.
All votes are in.
Let's see the votes. Unanimous approval of consent agenda items A and B, D through
J.
J. Okay.
So I understand.
Item number C.
I understand C, but I'm willing to bet that the majority looking at it won't. And so I want some verbal clarification on it, as we've had earlier. And then I want to talk about, as well, the two lease cars.
Okay.
Kim, you want to address that issue? Item number C, this is amendment, budget amendment number six.
So to clarify, you're wanting clarification on the reason why the 7,200
is 14.4.
Is 14.4. Because it's a revenue and an expenditure line item. And so in order for it to balance, that is how we do it for accounting. Mm-hmm. We're increasing a revenue line item and we're increasing the expenditure line item for 7,200.
I know that.
Okay.
But does everybody else know that?
Okay. And the questions about the two vehicles?
So let's be real clear on this, 7,200 times 7,200, we all know, we understand that, right?
It's 7,200
because as
plus,
you look at it, it's very, yeah. It's not very understandable.
Yeah,
it's a big number otherwise.
Okay, it looks like 14.4 for the banners is what it looks like. And it's the first time I've ever seen this type of accounting, to be quite frank.
how else would you?
I understand. I know. I'm with you 100%. But I'm just saying, as the public looking in and looking at this thing, it looks like 14,400.
Because I'm not decreasing anything. I mean, I have to increase revenue in order to increase expenditures.
So where's the increase of 14.4 coming from?
It's 7,200.
Okay.
I'm increasing revenue by 7,200.
So the other 7,200 is just a paper transaction.
And then you have an expenditure line item for 7,200.
Right. There you go.
Mm-hmm. And so, it falls under the same column. It's an increase in revenue and increase in expenditures. But it's just $7,200.
No, I understand.
Yeah.
Believe me, I understand how it gets there.
Yeah.
I'm just saying I think that the majority looking at it aren't going to. And the only reason I understand it is because you showed me the tick and tack that you do to get to it. Okay, but in a general rule of thumb and just looking at this thing, one would think 14.4, especially with a total of increase of 76,860, that 14.4 was increased to the general fund in this deal. Mm-hmm. Okay, but it's not.
Yeah.
$7,200 on paper.
Yeah.
One thing that might be helpful is remember it's a double entry accounting system. So every time you have a debit, you got to have a following credit. Mm-hmm. So it's got to be entered twice. And as she indicated, one is revenue
and then one's
expense. And,
right.
And the accounting system's a double entry system. So you will see two entries on each transaction.
I have a question. So you're reducing the computer and equipment by $62,000. What are we not going to buy? Is there things that we really probably need? We're going to wait for the following year. What are we not going to do now?
The $62,000 was for the purchase of those vehicles. We're lease purchasing them. And so I'm moving them from a capital purchase line item into a debt service line item.
Okay. I see grant fund decreasing computer equipment in the amount of $62,000. I thought that was for computer.
Mm-mm. It's computer / equipment. Equipment being the vehicles.
Oh, I see. Okay, the category.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's the reason I wanted to talk about that one. I just want to make sure that the general public is aware that we just approved 10 police cars, mm-hmm. okay, but that this deal was done prior to that, and it was done through a grant. Mm-hmm. Okay, because just in looking at this, it looks like just another two cars coming in when that's just not necessarily the case.
Right.
That's all. That's why I wanted it.
And this is the money that came from the from that grant that we had for victims. Chief, I can't remember the total name of it, but it's for the victims advocacy program.
Yes, sir.
And that's what, so this money is actually a part of that grant, but it was entered into, has to be entered into our books the way
yes,
Kim is now proposing
it.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
It is a debt service instead of a capital purchase.
Okay. All right. Any other? Okay, I will entertain then a motion to accept consent agenda item or to approve consent agenda item number C.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? Submit your votes.
All votes ran.
See the votes. Unanimous approval for consent agenda item number C. That moves us to the third item on our agenda, which is discussion and possible action resolution 2017-05, which is to waive some ordinances concerning the multiple sclerosis bike event, which is coming to town in September at Mineral Wells. Staff comments? Anybody?
Has that been through the park board?
It has not, to my knowledge. It has not been through the park board, to my knowledge. But this is the third year of the event where we've done this. This is the first year that it's in Mineral Wells Park. It has been in Highland Park in the past. And let's see here. They generally ask for use of the park. They bring, I don't know, several hundred cyclists into town. And they camp over at the park and usually use the whole thing and, you know, go through town. Hopefully they eat at restaurants and then leave Sunday morning. Usually the group comes in about a couple days prior to the event to start setting up.
And the two segments of the ordinance that this is talking about, one is the closing of the park, which has a closing time. This would allow it to be open the whole weekend that they are here.
Correct.
And then the other part deals with alcoholic beverages.
It does.
And this would allow them to have alcoholic beverages, and I think in years past it's been 3-2 beer that's mm-hmm. been donated.
Yes.
Is that the only two segments that we're talking about, Andrea?
It is, yes. It is. That's the same thing that they've requested the last couple years. And I know that, yeah, they do have donations of alcohol, that, and they do, I believe, some sort of wristband system. They police that. And then, yes, since they stay overnight, closing the park would kick them out.
Yeah. Let me ask you, with the new passes of the alcohol laws, does it have to be 3-2 beer still?
I don't think so.
I don't think it does.
No.
I think it can be High Point beer.
I think as long as they have their licensing through Able and the county, I think it's...
I think we can decide that.
And we've passed this the last 2 years. We've gone through this before, so this is more of just a housekeeping to let them do it.
Yeah. Chief, have we had any issues in years past, the last couple of years with this group? I know it's a good group. I know that they stop mm-hmm. here. They enjoy the stop. We enjoy them stopping.
Move to approve.
Nothing. Second.
They've done a good job.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any other discussion? Submit your vote, please.
All votes are in.
See the votes? Unanimous approval of resolution 2017-05. Item number 4 on the agenda, discussion and possible
action. That's off the agenda.
Why? What? I'm sorry? Mm.
4? The, four. Yes, we took off. Didn't we take 4 off of it?
Mm-mm. No.
We were going to recommend. Staff was going to recommend.
Oh, I thought you took it off.
No. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Item number 4, discussion, possible action to waive a portion of the Liberty Lake rules to allow the Oklahoma Equestrian Trail Riders Association to use ATVs to perform maintenance on the horse trails. Discussion? Or staff comments?
The only thing that I was going to suggest, and not to imply that staff is against the request, but as you indicated earlier, I don't believe it's been discussed at the park board level. And then secondly, it would be good to have some indication that the city council is favorable towards this, but it might be good to come back in the form of a resolution and have some standards and limitations on who can do it, and any requirements of that kind of stuff. So it's just not an open-ended where anybody could say they're out there doing maintenance. So just some housekeeping type things, not indicating it in any way that staff has a problem with them being able to do that for maintenance. We just want to make sure it's done in a written form that everybody understands what the limitations are.
And I'm sure you'll be involved with the park board and drafting that ordinance, right?
Yes, sir.
Can I? I'd like to move to table this.
I'll second that.
The park board.
I'll second it.
Okay.
There's
a motion and a second to move item number 4 to the park board for their consideration, and then brought back following their recommendations to the council. Is there any other discussion? Submit your votes.
All votes are in.
See the votes. Unanimous approval to submit that to the park board, that request by the Equestrian Trail Riders Association for park board's input and discussion, and then referral back to us with their recommendations. Item number 5 is discussion, possible action to appoint Stephen O'Neill to the forestry board. There are 2 forestry board openings at the present time. Mr. O'Neill is a retired professor, is leading the Oklahoma Gardeners, Master Gardeners program in Logan County, is the president, has a significant knowledge base there, and also is very interested in trying to do some things with some fruit trees throughout our city. So he is my recommendation to fill one of the vacant spots on the forestry board.
I got a question. I think he's well qualified. I don't have any problems with him. Just a little bit of process. Was he the only one who applied?
He is the only one that has applied.
Makes sense. Since there's 2 openings.
Yeah.
And the other one was, I mean, the type is a the it's written, right, and scanned. It's hard to read, and not saying that he's not the only one. I've noticed this in a lot of applications. It's hard to read it. Could we not move to more of a typable form where they get it, and they, maybe it's online, and they can actually type it? I mean, a lot of forms we use are typable, and you can add the answers so you can actually read these clearly. Here it's like I'm trying to decipher the words, and this guy is well-educated, but you know, we don't write as much as we used to, right? And I think it'd be nice if we could maybe look into, maybe Leroy, look into more of a typable form so we can see, read it more smoothly.
Fillable.
That would be helpful. What do you think? I think it'd help me to read this. Is that something we can investigate?
We can take a look at it.
Yeah.
We can look into that, and it'll depend on our safe software capabilities. But surely if we have the software, we can come up with a form that you
can like an Adobe
complete
type
online.
It's like an Adobe type of thing.
Yes.
You go through our IT that
yes.
we use.
And I'm assuming that those that want to could still handwrite it, but a lot of people would type it if it was available.
And we can have it, if we have available on the website, that we can just, you know, download it, type it, and then email it to even. So you don't have to come to the city for it specifically.
Well, the form is available on the website.
Staff will explore that.
Okay. All right, back to the motion of Stephen O'Neill on to fill one of the two forestry board positions.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Motion second. Is there any other discussion? Submit your votes. See the votes. Unanimous approval of Stephen O'Neill to the forestry board. City manager report. First report of
it's
his
gonna be,
tenure.
It's going to be lengthy. I started.
Hang on.
Just some of the things I've done. The Historic Preservation Committee meeting last night. I briefly attended the meeting just to introduce myself to the commission, and so they would know who I was, and make them aware that I do plan to assist them and participate. This morning we had a department head staff meeting. Initially during my tenure, we will have a staff meeting every Tuesday at 9 a.m. Later, as I get more indoctrinated, we may go to once every 2 weeks, but right now we're going to meet every week. At the staff meeting, we scheduled department briefing and tours of the city departments. And so on Thursdays, I will be out quite a bit the next few weeks doing tours of the department. What I've asked staff to do is provide me a review of the status of their current year's budget, so that I can see where they're at as far as their spending and where they're going the year as they project, what staff has included in the funding of their budget, an organizational chart. I want to see the facilities and equipment review and inspections of those facilities and equipment. I'm interested in the age, the man hours or mileage on the equipment, remaining life expectancy, replacement costs that they see in the future, conditions of their facilities and what deferred maintenance we have on those facilities, meet department staff, don't plan to create overtime on the departments that need be. I may have to go back at shift change or at different times to meet all the department staff, briefing on department duties and responsibilities, and indication of future needs relative to staffing, equipment, facilities. And I think that will give me a good basis to get to know the various departments. And so that's what I've asked them to prepare. And we have each department scheduled. I would like to do something similar where I schedule meetings with major employers and community leaders in the community to get to know our major employers, our community leaders. As time frees up and good afternoons, I'd like to spend some time in the afternoon just walking up and down the downtown and get to know some of the merchants and introduce myself as I have time. We have a meeting with Kay Wade and the LCEDC Executive Committee tomorrow to start talking about our economic development efforts and how we might work jointly. There's some other from the city attending with me for that meeting. Friday, we have a meeting with the Rural Water District. We have an intern preparatory meeting with city staff on Thursday at 9 a.m. to prepare and brief me on that, since that'll be a new topic for me. I'll be attending the next due diligence committee meeting dealing with the potential purchase of property at the airport. And I'll be attending the next Guthrie Edmond Regional Airport Board meeting next Tuesday night at 6. So that's just an indication of some of the things that I've done since I've been here and things that I've already planned to do over the next few weeks.
All of that in 2 days?
Yes.
I would say you've been busy.
I try to be results-oriented. One thing, I would be remiss if I didn't thank staff and the community for the warm reception before the meeting. It's greatly appreciated to get off on a foot where you feel welcomed and you're well received in the community. I know there will be some speed bumps along the way over time, but a very gracious welcome to the community, and I appreciate the staff setting that up and for all the community that attended. Thank you, sir.
Good. Thank you, Leroy, and look forward to your wife joining you. And I understand you have purchased a home, and so we'll be moving in the next month or so.
Yes, sir.
So look forward to that. And if anybody out there wants to help with moving some boxes, I'm sure that you could use some of that help.
Volunteers are always appreciated.
Very good. Well, welcome aboard. Item number 7, comments from members of the City Council. I would just like to make the first comment, and that is to thank Kim Biggs. Kim took over as interim city manager in September. I know that time has just flown by for you, Kim, wearing a number of hats in addition to interim city manager, keeping us on the straight and narrow, keeping us moving forward. And you've done an outstanding job in doing that. I would like to express my personal appreciation and the appreciation of the council and the city for what you've done in that interim capacity. Kim, thank you so very, very much. Councilman Thomas.
I was just going to say it's pretty much that.
Welcome, Leroy. You can say it again.
Welcome, Leroy, and I know that no one's more happy to see him than her. it's good to have you aboard, Leroy, and she did do a great job in the interim, and that's about all I got to say tonight.
Okay. Councilman Bothroyd.
Welcome, Leroy, and Kim's invaluable, no question. And so we love her, and she does a great job here and always will. And I'll nominate Steve for the move.
Second.
Got a second?
We're not taking a vote.
Those in favor?
I'd hate to see a quorum out there.
Yeah. That's it for me.
Yeah.
Councilman John Wood.
It's very similar. Thank you, Kim. I know I've worked with you more in the last several months than before, obviously, because of your job, but I really appreciate all that you did in that time period, for sure. And Leroy, welcome aboard. Really appreciate you coming. You know, we picked Leroy for a lot of reasons. Some is just his demeanor, but also that he's had a long experience in a lot of different cities, as Steve had mentioned, a lot of years in different cities. He's got an amazing amount of experience, so I think we're incredibly lucky to have him, and I hope he sticks around. And so we've struggled with that a little bit. He's my fifth manager in 8 years, so I'm just hoping he maybe stays here 8-10 years. We'll see.
Well, he'll probably be your final one. That's
yeah,
around.
Yeah. Well, he'll be my final one for sure. He'll be my final one for sure. But I just hope he sticks around the next few councils. Right. So, all right. Well, that's it.
Councilman Edwood.
Echoing everybody else, Leroy, welcome to Guthrie. Thank you for taking the challenge that you'll have with us. And don't kick me too hard sitting next to you. get out of hand. I mean, Kim used to kick me really hard. It was really bad. And again, thank you, Kim, for taking care of everything and keeping us all straight and narrow. So, welcome to Guthrie.
Thank you.
Look forward to meeting your family.
Thank you.
Councilman Taylor.
I'll just echo what they have to say. And also, thank you, Kim. Staff, appreciate what you all do. And you got new chairs, I noticed. So I appreciate that. It's kind of at least they don't squeak and move around quite so bad. So, and then one last thing. How about those Cowboys? Sorry. I'd throw that in there.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Councilwoman Padgett.
It's very difficult to speak last, all these eloquent speeches. I do want to agree with all the council members, everything being said, Leroy. So nice to have you here. And Kim, you did do a great job. I'm very proud of you. And I am also proud of the staff because it's difficult at best to work under a coworker, but you all did a great job. Absolutely heard great things about it. Thank you and congratulations.
Yeah. I'm glad Kim was able to have a few staff meetings so that they're not in shock when they have to have staff meetings scheduled.
I've got a couple comments. We did approve a volunteer to the forestry board tonight, but we still have one vacancy for the forestry board that meets quarterly bimonthly. I've corrected. Would certainly like to have some citizens step up to that. As a matter of fact, we've got a position in the Board of Adjustment. We have one vacancy there. That closes this week. So if you're interested in the viewing public out there or in the arena here, please get that application in. Historic Preservation also has a vacancy and it closes on the 24th of this month. And the Planning Commission has a number of terms that are expiring. Three individuals that are presently on the commission, terms are expiring. They can obviously still reapply for those positions, but three positions that are application is closing again on the 24th of this month. The library has got a number of wonderful things going on this month for Black History Month. I don't know if you want to get up and say a few things. Our library is magnificent, folks. And if you haven't visited, you need to, because it is clearly a gem of the community. And this month is very, very special. We've got a number of great things going on.
That is correct. This past Saturday, we had our second annual Crowns Tea. It is honoring the significance of the church hat for African Americans. And so we had about 20 people show up in very fancy hats, and we had tea, and we talked about their experiences. This coming Saturday, we are celebrating, we are partnering with the Historical Society and the Masonic Temple and showing the civil rights documentary. There was a huge civil rights movement here in Oklahoma City that many people don't know about, and a documentary was created. So there will be two showings. And at the end of this month, we are having an author visit. So in addition to these events, we have several other events going on. If you want to learn about Medicare, if you want to learn how to be a writer, if you want to have your taxes prepared for free, if you make under $54,000, we have the VITA program at the library from now until April 14th, 15th, because you get two extra days this year. So there's a lot going on at the library.
Awesome. Visit your library. Lots going on, as she said. And when I mentioned Black History, I'd like to congratulate everybody that's involved with the Taste and Tell. The food was magnificent, I think I sampled just about every single one of the food items that each church had, so it was great. And also congratulations to United Way of Logan County. They had a goal of $180,000 for their goal, kind of a stretch goal, and their celebration or their contributions was $191,000. They just smashed the heck out of that goal. So congratulations to them. Last word, we have a vote going on, a primary vote coming on the next week. Yeah, on the
tell us about
14th. Award one, We have three individuals that are vying for John's seat and so in the primary.
So who are they? Can you tell us a little bit about them?
No, I thought you would.
No, go ahead.
It's on the chamber chat.
It's on the chamber chat.
You can you can hear their interviews there.
Good. Anyway, just vote. Get out and vote. That's an opportunity for those individuals that reside in that ward. Okay. Item number eight is consider approval to convene into executive session for three elements, A, B, and C. A being discussion of the purchase of real property, the Hussman property. B is discussion purchase of appraisal of real property concerning the airport property, and C is purpose of discussing confidential communications concerning an investigation and claim in the Mark Bruning case.
So moved.
Sir, you had a motion and a second?
Okay. Yes, second.
Okay, any other discussion? Submit your votes.
All votes are in.
See the votes. Unanimous approval to convene into